Good evening again. Just a quick reminder, we'll be starting in a few minutes, but again, the college has asked that households, of course, are free to sit together, but please do leave us a seat. Thank you.
good. Thank you. All right. Good evening. Let us begin. Let us start this celebration of our 2021 Cedar graduates. Good evening, secondary families near and far. Good evening, secondary students. Good evening, Cedar faculty. Good evening, special guests. With us tonight, we welcome you all, and we hope you enjoy the celebration of the class of 2021. Let me take this moment to say a special welcome to His Excellency, Governor Mr. John Rankin. In addition, a special welcome to the Honorable Vincent O. Wheatley, Minister for Natural Resources, Labor, Immigration, and the 9th District Representative. Good evening. Good evening to our special guests, dignitaries, and well-wishers. This is a big night. So we're gonna need a lot of your support by making as much noise as you can for our graduates at every possible opportunity. There we go. We need it. That's it, that's a good start, that's a good start. I've done this a few times, and I can honestly say that I am so grateful and happy that we're able to celebrate this very special class here tonight. As you know, this year has been unlike any other year. It's been challenging and certainly different. We tried to plan ahead, but yet had to take things week by week and sometimes day by day. But here we are in this indeed little different year. This year's also been incredibly inspiring in many, many ways. And this class is actually a perfect example of inspiring, as you'll hear tonight. We have a lot to celebrate. And as an educator, again, there's really no finer thing to be a part of than this moment tonight. So let us begin. Would everyone please rise, as it is with great pleasure to welcome the distinguished class of 2021 to the stage. There they are, the class of 2021. How about another big round of applause one more time for them? I'd like to now introduce one of our absolute rising stars, Miss Tatiana Foy, who will be singing the national anthem and territorial song. So please rise again.
To raise. ancestors bled and died, but with strength and with power we overcame to restore the Virgin Islands' pride. To preserve your beauty, we devised a plan to obtain ownership of your precious land. Educating your people is the golden key to maintain the success of this territory. Richly bless this territory. May we ask three things of thee: courage for our great leaders, that they may rule our destiny. We ask for wisdom for our people, that they may live in harmony and understanding for our children, that they may cherish this legacy. Oh, how radiant are your daughters, and how wealthy are your sons. Your beaches boast your beauty, and your success is second to
I'll be seated. Thank you. I would like to now take this moment to introduce the director of Cedar International School, Mr. Scott Crawford.
Good evening, everyone. And Tatiana, thank you for that beautiful rendition. That was phenomenal. Allow me to echo Mr. Pasco in welcoming all of you to Cedar's commencement ceremony for the class of 2021. I acknowledge the protocol established, and we're very pleased to have the governor and the minister with us here this evening. I also wish to bid welcome to the members of Cedar's Board of Trustees, some of whom have children graduating this evening. And to parents, family, and friends of the graduates, all of Cedar's teachers and staff in attendance this evening. And finally, a hearty welcome to the class of 2021. That's, yeah. Realize I also usually acknowledge our alumni, and I've seen some out there. Any alumni out there wish to stand and be recognized? There we go. Always good to see them back. I'd like to extend thanks to HLSCC for allowing us the use of their beautiful auditorium. It's a reminder of the days before Irma, when we would host our graduations here each year. And the last few years have certainly been anything but normal, but our return here hopefully represents a small step on the road back to normalcy. Now, looking at the calendar, it's worth noting that this graduation ceremony actually marks the completion of 20 years for Cedar at its Kingstown campus. A very nice milestone, and in that sense, it's very fitting, actually, that Percy Roden, by happy coincidence, is our commencement speaker, as he and his team at Meridian were instrumental in building that campus, a campus that has served us well for two decades now, offering strength in the face of Irma, adaptability in the face of a global pandemic, and is now full of memories of all the students who have passed through its corridors, learned in its classrooms, and played on its grounds since the 2001-2002 school year, a time venerable enough to predate the birth of any graduate on this stage today. Yes. But 20 years on, the class of 2021 very much stands as a marker of where Cedar is today. And if that is the case, we have good reason to be pleased. With 17 students, they match our largest graduating class to date. They represent 6 different nationalities overall, and 10 of the 17 students are BV Islanders or belongers. It's a class with longevity. Of the 17 students, 10 were already enrolled at Cedar by grade 3. And 3, I think, started all the way back in pre-kindergarten. Yeah. So, as they graduate tonight, they have collectively received offers from 42 universities in 4 different countries, and scholarship offers totaling more than $400,000. And they will be pursuing diverse courses of study, ranging from astrophysics to nursing and lots in between. So it is a very talented class, and we are extremely proud of them, and know we couldn't ask for better ambassadors as we conclude our 20th year at Kingstown, our 31st overall. They will be a sterling addition to our alumni community, and we look forward to celebrating them tonight and congratulating them all on a job well done. That celebration will begin now with the presentation of a number of special awards.
Thank you, Mr. Crawford. All right, so we're going to continue this celebration by commending some of our outstanding Cedar students with some very special Cedar awards. These awards include the Cedar Sportsmanship Award, the Nathaniel Wheatley Prize for Excellence in Information Technology, the Mark and Jeanette Forte Performing Arts Award, and the coveted Cedar Award. So to begin, I'm going to have Coach John, Coach Riley, come on up and let us know who won the Cedar Sportsmanship Award this year.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This year's winner of this award, I've had the privilege and honour to work with, I'm beginning into my 8th year. There's so many things I could say about this young man. It's you know, we'll be here till next week. Academically, athletically, he's an absolute example to follow. I'm lucky enough, again, to be working with him. He's taught me so many things and all. He's my secretary when I go with him in the football. He looks after me as much as I look after him. I learn a lot from him. I've learned a lot from these. Every time I'm stuck, I can ask you. They are great ambassadors for the school. They will always help me, always looking a way to help people. But this particular young man, he's... I'll go to where we are now with him. He plays football for the BVI national team at 17. He he made his international debut in a World Cup qualifier. How incredible is that? And now he's also going to play international squash in the Pan Am Games at 17. He'll be 18 then, but it's an incredible journey. And if I can give you a little example of the character of this young man, we was in a qualifier. It was in Guatemala, and we had amongst the players and the staff, we had a consequence wheel, which is if you're late, you spin the wheel. And on the wheel could be a $40 fine, a $20 fine. One of them could be you've got to ring up your manager and ask to be the captain of the team now that you've planned for the national team. So there's various ones like singing, jumping in the swimming pool. And after a few days went on, a couple of people approached this young man and said, why are you never on the consequence wheel? Now, this, I think, is braver than anything. He turned around and said, because I'm a good kid. You won't see me up there. Which I think was the bravery in itself. So, again, I have nothing but admiration for this young man, his family, what he's learned from his family. He's a good leader, good ambassador. Again, on one of the games we played, we was being run ragged by a team of top professional international players. And I said to him, do you want to come off? And this is his, this sums up his character. He went, I'll run until I drop. He said, then you can take me off. So there's his character, you know. He leads by example. And I've had the pleasure of being on this journey with him. And his journey will continue now until his university in Canada, Western University. And I honestly think they're very lucky to have him. And I, for one, will miss this boy. Really missed him, along with his family. So this year's winner at the Cedar Sportsmanship Award, I think we know, don't we, is Luca Reich.
Thank you, Coach John, and congratulations, Luca. Okay, moving on. We're now going to have Mr. Thibault come up and talk to us a little bit about the Excellence in Information Technology at Cedar. Give Mr. Thibault a big, warm welcome.
Good evening, everyone. The Nathaniel Whitley Prize of Excellence in Information Technology is an annual award which is given to a student who excels and is passionate in this subject of information technology, IT. So we do have a few excellent students in IT at the school. And I really like that the fact that they participate all the time in classes, but also support their peers, support everyone in IT. And they have been very consistent in providing support to everyone. Most importantly, through a small club that they did, a club called Sci-Fi, in which, sure, they do science, they do physics, but also do IT and maths. So thank you very much for those students that support them. One of them in particular I would like to recognize tonight, because he has been consistent in achieving the highest mark in computer science, as I said, but also in supporting his peers, helping them all along. So next year, he's going to pursue a degree in computer science to Jacobs University, and it is my privilege to give this award to Max Esser. Come on, Max.
All right, congratulations, Max. Well done. Thank you, Mr. Thibault. Let me take this moment just to say a special welcome to Dr. the Honorable Natalie D. Wheatley, Deputy Premier, Minister of Education, Culture, Youth Affairs, Fisheries and Agriculture. Welcome, thank you so much. All right, the next award is the Mark and Jeanette Forte Performing Arts Award. I'm gonna call up my colleague, Mr. Butcher, to give that award. Let's give him a round of applause.
Good evening. I would first like to start by thanking Mark and Jeanette yet again for their amazing support for the performing arts at Cedar. It's been a number of years now. It's an amazing thing that they've done. Thank you. This award is for outstanding commitment to the performing arts, demonstrating enthusiasm in sharing talents with others in the local community. So it's important that they are able to show outstanding talent, but also that they share that within the school and the community. The person that's won this award this year is an outstanding talent, one of the most outstanding talents I've ever worked with. She's done a lot of work in the community. She plays in the Pan Band. She has... She has absolute maximized all her marks, semester one, semester two, full marks, which has never happened before with any of my students. We recently did a project which was a jukebox video musical, and although I wrote some of the backing tracks, I was always amazed when the next day she would turn up with a track much better than the one I just composed, which we would then use instead. A truly, truly outstanding talent that plays pan, piano, bass, and sings incredible. So this year, the award goes to Jade Farina. Thank you.
She was a little surprised. Congratulations, Jade. Okay, before I call on my next colleague to give out the Cedar Award, I want to properly recognize and introduce her. Together, Ms. Dixon and I have been working side by side for quite some time, over 9 years, I think. We both started out in the science department as science teachers, and we've worked closely in the secondary leadership team the past couple of years. We've been through hurricanes and pandemics and a few very, very interesting teachers who always kept us on our toes and humored us, that's for sure. Sarah's been an absolute instrumental key faculty member in the secondary team. And her family will be relocating to Florida next year, but I'm sure we'll see quite a lot of her as she'll be back and forth and visiting us as much as absolutely possible. We will ensure that. So please give me a little bit of help in welcoming Ms. Sarah Dixon to the podium to give out the Cedar Award.
Thank you. Thank you for that. Good evening, everyone. Tonight, I have the honor of presenting this year's Cedar Award. The Cedar Award is given annually to the grade 12 student who demonstrates outstanding commitment and dedication to academic and non-academic activities, contributes to a positive atmosphere during their time at Cedar, and is an embodiment of the 10 IB learner profile traits in action. The recipient of tonight's Cedar Award has had a long journey at Cedar, beginning in the primary years program and continuing through the MYP, where he made his mark with his personal project by starting the Soccer Sisters Club to encourage young girls to get involved in football. In his transition from MYP to DP, this young man has had all the right stuff, managing to balance the rigors of the diploma program with being a captain for his house team, continuing to lead the soccer sisters, and representing the territory on the national teams for both football and squash. Please will you join me in congratulating the recipient of the 2021 Cedar Award, Luca Reich.
Luca, well done again. Thank you. Yes, and thank you, Ms. Dixon. We will miss you, but I know we'll be seeing quite a lot of you. That is a wonderful part of the event, the evening, where it's just accommodations to all our students who are excelling in some of their fields, and it's wonderful to watch them grow in each and every one of those fields. So thank you very much for all our faculty for coming up and giving those awards out, and well done to all our well-earned students. I'm now gonna call up Mr. Scott Crawford to do a special recognition for congratulatory remarks.
Good evening again. We've been honored the last few years to have the Honorable Dr. Wheatley graces with his presence at our graduation. 2 years ago, it was as commencement speaker. Last year, he came in his role as both Deputy Premier and Minister of Ed, and he's back again in that role to offer congratulatory remarks to our graduates, and we're very grateful for his time. Minister.
Pleasant good afternoon to you. Such a pleasure to be here. Your Excellency, the Governor, Minister of Natural Resources, Labor and Immigration, Chair of the Board, Brother Thomas, Director, Brother Crawford, Administration, staff, teachers, parents, well-wishers, supporters, and especially the graduating class of 2021. It's a fantastic achievement. I'll just say a few words. I won't stay up here too long. But it's a fantastic achievement considering all the challenges of the past year. Certainly, we still have challenges related to recovery from the hurricanes. And this year, we had the worst pandemic in 100 years, since the Spanish influenza, I believe, maybe around 1919, somewhere around there. And in our public schools, we had challenges, but in the private schools, we had some unique challenges as it relates to COVID-19 and the protocols that we had to implement for everyone's safety. And of course, when persons are paying tuition to send their children to school, it's certainly very difficult when everyone has to go home. And so I appreciate the way that the administration here was patient and understanding and worked with us to get through that very difficult period when the schools were closed. And I appreciated all of the adjustments that Cedar International made to accommodate all the students here. And certainly, graduating class of 2021, you should give a round of applause to the parents and the administration and the teachers for making all of the accommodations to ensure that you got the very best education. And yes, you give yourselves a round of applause for your investment in your children, which is the investment in our future. And as a result of that hard work, which I thank you for, I thank you for all the hard work you've put in, administrators, parents, and teachers, we have some wonderful young people here who will be doing fantastic things in life. I've been able to interact with at least some of these young persons here, and I have to tell you, I'm very impressed with what Cedar is doing with their students and what Cedar is doing in the community. You have a diverse pool of students here, and many of them are fully involved in our community. When we have the different competitions across the territory, students at Cedar participate, and they do very well. And I will continue to be a strong partner for this school as you continue to invest in these young people and invest in our community. So on behalf of the government and on behalf of the Ministry of Education, I give a very special congratulations to you students. Continue reaching for the stars and doing the fantastic things that God created you to do. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Wheatley. All right, the band's coming out. We're heating up in here. We're getting ready. We got some exciting things in store. We got to get the graduates moving a little bit, I think, get them a little bit excited. So, graduates, while the Steel Pan Band is playing, we're going to have you go to your allocated, designated seats, leaving as you entered. All right, so you ready? Let's go. You're not graduated yet. We got a little ways to go. We're going to, you go that way, RJ. Yeah, and then, good job. So we just want to get you moving.
Good afternoon, everybody. So the secondary elective, they prepared a song specifically for the graduates today that they definitely wanted to sing for them. So hope you guys enjoy.
Stop you from
Cedar Steel Pan Band. Give them a round of applause again. Let's go. Well done. Big thanks to Mr. Butcher and Mr. Johnson. You guys are gurus, and that is fantastic to see. Well done, Cedar Steel Pan Band. I can say that. Mr. Crawford has to follow up next, so I'm just going to take those mics away. 1 minute.
Yeah, that's the second time tonight they've made me follow the talent. Really well done. Would you believe, we didn't even have those steel pans before January. So they've all pulled that off in 6 months. Real credit to the students and to Mr. Butcher and Mr. Johnson. Lots of good things happen in the music department. We're grateful for their efforts. Well done, Kiara. I don't know if you noticed her in her gown down there. She's wearing a couple hats tonight. So I now have the honor of diverting briefly from the ceremony to offer special recognition to Cedar's former board chair, Mr. Mark Forte, who retired from the position earlier this school year. It's appropriate that the recognition comes on the heels of that impressive performance. Because as Mr. Butcher noted, Mark and his wife Jeanette have been staunch supporters of the music program at Cedar, donating to the Steel Pan Fund earlier this year, sponsoring the Performing Arts Award for more than 10 years now. But that support is just one of the many ways that Mark has contributed to the Cedar community. I've been fortunate to have my tenure as head of school coincide with the entirety of his tenure as board chair. So I've had a closer look than most at the energy and care he's brought to the leadership role. Mark presided over a time of rapid growth of our secondary school and our programs. He championed and gave generously to our scholarship program and inspired others to do the same. He spearheaded big projects like land acquisition and payroll tax relief. He worked tirelessly to keep the school operational after Irma. He buoyed spirits during the pandemic by bringing pizzas to our staff when the school went online. And he even leveraged his contacts at the North Pole to ensure Santa Claus showed up at season's greetings year after year after year. He has certainly earned my admiration and gratitude and has inspired confidence throughout our school community. And we are truly grateful for all he has done. When university professors retire, they often are gifted a rocking chair from their institution. So it seems a fitting way to honor a person who has contributed so much to Cedar's success over the years to present Mark with this, I don't know if it's projected, but this teak rocking chair, which Arawak has made special just for him. Is it up there? Yeah. We were hoping to have the actual chair on stage this evening so Mark could come up and try it out for us. But due to global shipping challenges, it will be here in a few weeks. So Mark will have to wait just a bit to start rocking. In the meantime, however, we do have a gift he can enjoy now and hopefully for years to come. And is that, I can't see, is it projected? Excellent, excellent. So it's a framed photo collage capturing some of the many hats Mark wore in his time as Cedar's board chair. If you look closely, you will see an enthusiastic bidder at our annual gala. You will see the pizza delivery man aforementioned earlier, a very jolly Santa, an inspirational speaker, And most importantly, you will see a Cedar father whose children have grown up on our campus, the youngest of which, Jasper, graduates this evening. We also included a lovely photo of Mark with his wife, Jeanette, to recognize her many contributions over the years as they've made their support of Cedar a whole family commitment. The inscription on the collage reads, "The Cedar community thanks Mark Forte for the commitment, generosity, love, and leadership he demonstrated throughout his tenure as chair of Cedar's Board of Trustees. His efforts have made Cedar a wonderful place for children, including his own, to grow and learn." We've had it framed in matching teak so it will look good next to his rocking chair. Mark, can you please come to stage to collect your gift and be recognized?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests. A rocking chair. I guess that means it's time to retire. And not before time. Before I go, which I have done already, let me just give way to the class whose night it is tonight, but to assure you all that my successor is a man of great energy and will provide great leadership. I'm sure in many ways better leadership, as time goes on, for many, many years, Gareth. I tried to think of something to draw an analogy between the class starting and finishing, especially my own children, and seeing Jasper tonight come from kindergarten to graduation. Mr. Boo. I thought, was there some great legal analogy we could draw upon? The answer is no. It's like pizzas, really. You put them in at one temperature, and a little while later, they come out fully baked. And in many ways, this class is fully baked. Or maybe it will be. But the point is this, that many of these young adults were the same people we held their hand walking into kindergarten gate. Saw them play, saw them grow up together, and saw them welcome their colleagues. And if there's one point of inspiration that I would like to share, it's this. What we've tried to do over the years at Cedar is create a community school, an international school in the community. And when you look at this class, my advice, for what it's worth, is that you will always draw upon each other. And in the last year and a half, you've never had to do that more so, ironically, from being so distant, to draw upon each other so closely, and that will be forged for life. And that's what we've tried to do, and I think we've done a good job, and it will continue to do so. So my thanks to the school for the absolute privilege for giving it a number of years, and thank you all very much, Vita.
Thank you, Mark. One of the things about an independent nonprofit school run by volunteer board members is that they do indeed plan for continuity to ensure stability of operations and programs as board members move on. So proving that point, it is now my pleasure to introduce Cedar's new board chair, Mr. Gareth Thomas. Gareth is the managing director of Arcorian's BVI office. He joined Cedar's Board of Trustees in 2014, serving in a variety of roles, including vice chair, before becoming chair in October of last year. He's been a Cedar dad for even longer, with his son Ty having just completed grade 9, rising to grade 10 next year. So I'm very pleased to welcome Gareth to the microphone now to offer remarks to the graduates and to our school community on behalf of the Board of Trustees.
Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to be up here this evening under the lights. We're delighted to have our distinguished guests here this evening. Governor Rankin, this is your first graduation. It's a pleasure to have you, hopefully many more. Ministers Wheatley, you are no strangers to this, and we are absolutely thrilled that you're here tonight and continue to be great friends to Cedar. So thank you. We also have another distinguished guest. He'll be speaking later. The best dressed man in the BVI, Percy Roden. Cedar has been around for over 30 years. It has grown from very humble beginnings on the backs of those who've gone before us to now where we are graduating another extremely talented and well-rounded set of young men and women ready to tackle the next adventure in life. Just following on a moment from Scott's remarks, I came on the board 7 years ago. I think, Mike, me and you joined about the same time, I believe. And we've got to see firsthand the commitment of people like Mark and people like Walter in what they have done and continue to do for this school, behind the scenes, with no fanfare or fuss, quietly working away for the good of the school and for the good of everyone involved in it. As the incoming chair, I would just like to say this. Cedar owes a debt of gratitude, the size of which few people will ever know, both to Mark as the retiring chair and to Walter for the work, seen and unseen, and for what is still to come from them both. So thank you. If we could just have a round of applause for both of them, please. Over the past year, we in the BVI and the world as a whole have had to navigate the first pandemic of our lifetime. The school was nimbly able to switch to remote working without missing a beat back in March 2020. But more importantly, as my good friend Natalia Wheatley pointed out earlier, we were able to shuffle and work very closely with the Ministry of Education to be in a position to open our doors on campus in September. We did that, and I'm delighted to say we haven't missed a day since on campus since then. When you stand back and compare this to schools all around the world, it is a truly amazing and significant achievement. The rest of the world have had to put up with parents trying to homeschool their children, and even worse, children having to put up with homeschooling from their parents. This, in normal times, would be challenging. But the class of 21, over the last 4 years, have had to deal with this pandemic, with Irma, with a grueling IB schedule, and turning from teen to adult all at the same time. So with a look to the future, we have many exciting things to look forward to at Cedar. We have the new pitch being installed this summer. Again, huge shout out to Walter there for everything he's done. We've now taken management of the lunchbox with a new revamped menu, which I believe is working very well. And huge thanks to Vernie for everything she's done there to make that work smoothly. Thank you, Vernie. And of course, we have the new land. The board is very open to ideas, fresh and old, as we look to explore the great opportunities that await in terms of expanding our campus or partnerships with the right fit. So I would just say this. If you have any nuggets or any leads, please approach us. You can consult me or Scott or any board member. We are open to some great ideas, so please come forward. I'll just finish by saying this. I'm very proud of our little school. It has matured and grown over the years in terms of the quality of education it offers, the caliber of graduates it produces, and increasing our role and increasing our place within the BVI community. BVI that we all call home. So more to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Gareth. I'm feeling lonely up here, that's for sure. This empty stage. And we're missing our graduates. I'm going to call the graduates back up. That's better, because it's getting lonely up here.
I'm going to bring this up.
Oh, you are? All right, each year the graduating students choose a faculty member to speak on behalf of the secondary faculty. This faculty member is significant in the matriculation of our students in so many ways. And he's an absolute wonderful choice to represent the faculty and address the class of 2021. So a special warm welcome to Mr. Derek Matthews.
Got framed. Ambush.
A tribute for all our class jokes and fun that we've had. So just so that you can reach the microphone. You know, it has a handle.
You couldn't get a new one?
That was... We had a bow, but it got lost in transit.
That's more like it. Thank you, grade 12. You will regret that. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Graduating class of 2021, parents, friends, family, staff, and distinguished guests. When grade 12 asked me to make a speech on their behalf as faculty representative, I felt quite positive, quite honored, that I would have something meaningful to say about them. I sought the counsel and the input of many of their teachers, and we, as a faculty, based on the suggestions the teachers passed to me, decided to entitle this particular speech, Revenge. Yeah, you should be nervous. As a society, we like to use labels, especially for generations or for age ranges. Labels like millennials, Generation Z, Generation X, baby boomers, and so on. And as I was thinking about this class, I wondered how they would be remembered. I wondered if there was one catch-all label that could fit all of them. Given the COVID-19 pandemic that unfortunately dominated their final school year, I think it would be appropriate to call this class of 2021 the quarantine generation. The quarantines are a class who are way ahead of their time. This is a class who are practicing COVID-19 protocols long before they became popular. For instance, the class socially distanced themselves from completing their extended essays on time. They self-isolated far away from their internal assessment deadlines. Very well done to the quarantiners, the class of 2021. Given that they've literally put me on this pedestal, I'm going to ask them to please stand and make their way back to their seats. I will, in turn, speak about each of the graduating class of 2021, the quarantiners. But before I do, I want the class to be able to see on screen the secret hidden camera footage from the tent for the whole year. Yeah, who's laughing about the ladder now? Jokes aside, we are going to watch some highlights of some of the students themselves and some familiar faces who, although not graduating today, are very much a part of the class. So please enjoy the highlights of the students in their own very carefully chosen words.
Renaissance era, our contestants are Thomas Tallis.
Hi, I'm the best ventriloquist ever. Look at this.
Hello, I like to drink tea. Please may you give me my tea. When's it supper time? Please may I have some roast pork and gravy with the Yorkshire pudding?
Ooh.
Random hair change.
All right, and also Madama Anna Inglese.
Fire eating?
We could do fire eating,
juggling,
acrobatics,
dancing,
we can play instruments,
conjuring,
singing,
reciting poems,
and animal training.
Yay! I'm crunchy!
Come and see Thomas Tallis and some of my Renaissance friends such as Claudio Monteverdi and William Byrd, Giovanni Gabrielli, Orlando de la Suze, Don Carlo, Gesualdo, and some of my favorite instruments such as the sackbut, lute, racket, crumb horn at the giant Wembley.
Bye!
No.
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 Sorry, but yes!
Fire!
Can someone get Renny off my face?
Okay.
I'm Hildegard von Bingen.
That was amazing. Just amazing. Now, Thomas, you're next.
Okay, let me just get my spell.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, in particular to Mr. Butcher, who found such brilliant footage from his archive. Quarantines, time to make your way back up onto the stage. Max Esser, ladies and gentlemen, starring at the end of the clip there. 65 consecutive push-ups in grade 10. That's why Max is so quiet in class. He's still tired. I've actually never seen Max eat lunch at school. But Max, you can be sure that England will eat Germany for lunch tomorrow in the football. Max is an erudite young man, calm, diligent, great poise, full of ideas. He is the mad scientist of push-ups. I wish him the very best for next year. Amelia Adamson, head girl, debate team captain, debate team champion. Amelia is a multifaceted student who has courage and will in abundance. She's driven and determined. Being in Barracuda's house, Amelia also knows what it's like to lose again and again, year on year. Amelia has been a trailblazer for her age, advocating for equality, fairness, and personal responsibility. Amelia will leave very big shoes to fill here at Cedar. Max Reshetiloff. Max is a terrific young man. Max is kind, he's personable, and he's very inquisitive. Max will set sail, quite literally, for the Massachusetts Maritime Academy. Max has a very bright future, and he has all of the potential in the world to go on to become a very, very, very good pirate. Max will now go on to study the business of buccaneering. Take a bow, Max. I'm sure you will seize the day in Massachusetts. I wish Max all the very best for next year. Lakeisha, calm, disciplined, and sincere. At times, she can be quite quiet and reserved in class. But in fairness, that may be because she had to sit directly opposite me in a tent for the best part of a year. Lakeisha is a young lady with a big heart and big ambitions. She survived almost being poisoned by her math teacher on the morning of her math exam. Now, Lakeisha knows that nothing can stop her. Lakeisha has been a pleasure to teach, and the state of New York's gain is Cedar's loss. Haley, an incredible cartoonist. When it is time to be artistic, Haley is easily motivated and draws on her wonderful imagination. One of my fondest memories of last year is having the privilege of watching Haley step well outside of her comfort zone and play a big role in helping the school win the national debate competition. Haley is a young lady for whom the future is hard to predict. She is someone who could go anywhere and do anything. Absolutely, all the best for next year, Haley. Janiqua, rational, diligent, kind-hearted, multi-talented. Janiqua is an old head on very young shoulders. I believe tonight is also Janiqua's 15th birthday. Happy birthday, Janiqua. You know, if university doesn't work out, you're always welcome back at Cedar into grade 9. Janika embodies the best of what we hope Cedar students to be. Hard work and diligence are essential to success, but they do require an internal motivation. That internal motivation is named Janiqua. I wish her the very best for next year. Josh, head boy, performing artist, dependable dolphin. Josh is a very good-humored young man with remarkable confidence. He's a great presence in class. Josh is quick-witted. He's confident. He's alert. He's attentive. He's none of these things at 8 a.m. on a Monday morning. But still, Josh is a student who brings out the very best in others. He's been a real pleasure to teach, and I will sincerely miss his positive and sarcastic support in class. Michaela. Wow, home crowd, Michaela. Kind-hearted, brave, and quietly tenacious. These traits served Michaela well as Barracuda's House co-captain last year. Being a proud Barracuda, she knows what it's like to finish fourth out of four. But Michaela remains undaunted. Michaela leaves a lasting impression on me because of her honesty and her compassion. She's been a pleasure to teach. All the best for next year, Michaela. Kinesia. A debate team star, an artist, a young lady who best embodies the IB learner profile attribute of principled. Kinesia would probably make a very good school principal, although I think she has ambitions to be a lawyer. She does already have many of the necessary traits. She swears a lot, and her time is money. Kinesia does have a remarkable sense of fairness and justice. She conducts herself with dignity and remarkable composure. Kinesia is a real credit to herself and to her family. Jasper. Intelligent, candid, and very entrepreneurial. Full of ideas and innovation. He's also the go-to student for your lunch order. When I think of Jasper, I think of an entrepreneur. I think he may well go on to become the Elon Musk of East End, the Walt Disney of West Bay, the Zuckerberg of Zion Hill. Jasper has approached uncertainty with forethought and determination. I will wonder what he does, because I am sure that he will do it very well. Jake. Jake is a smart, dutiful, and determined student who has been a pleasure to teach. He completed excellent internal assessments, particularly in business management and English, and he handed these in on time. Time is an interesting challenge for Jake. From Jake's perspective, he's not late for an 8 a.m. class. Everyone else is early. Jake is an excellent communicator. He's a willing collaborator, and he's a lovely young man. Good luck for next year, Jake. Anton, fastidious and dedicated. Along with Max Esser, he's taught math support classes to MYP students this year. Anton is an absolute pleasure to teach. He's consistently curious. But just before Anton graduates, I would like to check with Mr. Tebow and Mr. Gabbani. Did he finally hand in the world's most overdue extended essay? There's a lot of no's. I think hopefully the IB isn't watching. Following Anton's many years of dedication at Cedar, he has decided now to take the easy route of studying astrophysics next year. Well done, Anton. I wish you all the best. Luca, Dolphins co-captain, internationally capped footballer for the British Virgin Islands. Luca is a diligent and resourceful young man of terrific character and personality. Even though he is a Chelsea fan, I was willing to write a letter of recommendation for him recently. My recommendation was support a different football team. Luca is an outstanding role model for younger Cedar students and will be a very hard act to follow. Best of luck for the future. Paswa, organized, loyal, resilient. Paswa came into the DP program late, in January of grade 11. And then, only 3 months later, we went into lockdown and online learning. Paswa's attitude and application to catch up, recover, and find her balance have been extraordinary. What is also extraordinary is Paswa's ability to type 60 words per minute with those fingernails. Remarkable stuff. Paswa is a driven and dynamic young lady. She is a good example for students that it is not the circumstances of how you start, but how well you finish. Best of luck for next year, Paswa. Tania, laser-focused, an international BVI footballer in numerous positions, Dolphins co-captain. She's one of the most dependable and purposeful students that I've ever taught. I believe Tania is heading to Nova Scotia in Canada, or is maybe already there right now. My leaving present to Tania would be the same, a big winter coat. She will be irreplaceable at Cedar. Round of applause for Tania, please. RJ, my Spanish teacher. He does occasionally teach me Spanish. Just the clean words, please, RJ, nothing rude. I think RJ actually has the potential to be a very good teacher. I've noticed him teaching Spanish to one of the students in our audience on the terrace at school over the last few weeks. Everyone can look at Rush now in the middle there if you want to. And he seems to be doing an outstanding job of teaching Rush Spanish. And maybe that could be the secret to RJ's success. Don't be a student in the class. Teach the class. So it is no more Senor Fortnite. It is now Senor RJ. RJ is not only bilingual. He is more so a self-assured, warm-spirited, and patient young man. ¿Dónde está, por favor, RJ? What I would actually like to say is gracias and mucha suerte, RJ. Kiara. What a comeback. On Sports Day last week, Kiara showed up and helped to lead her Stingrays and inspire those Stingrays to their first Sports Day win in many, many years. House Champions 2021. What a captain Kiara is. Kiara is also a marvelous musician and a young lady of courage, character, and candor. I wish her the very best for next year in whatever she does. The IB learner profile has been a big part of this class's lives for many years. The learner profile represents 10 attributes valued by IB World Schools. And what have grade 12 learned from their years in the DP program, particularly their 2 years in business management class with me? Let's have a look at some of the learner profile attributes. Let's see if we can pick some out that match this class. inquirers. So this would be things like asking lots of good questions, having a love for learning. Yes, that is this grade 12 class, because nothing says love of learning like everyday questions such as, can we watch Shark Tank today? Or when is the next fire drill? Or what time is lunch today, Mr. Matthews? Always the same time. All great questions from the quarantines. It shows them to be diligent inquirers and critical thinkers. That leads straight into another attribute, thinkers. Thinkers, grade 12, thinking. You should try that one. Critical thinkers, yes. I could be critical of your level of thinking. But more seriously, when I go through the attributes, balanced, caring, open-minded, knowledgeable, all of these attributes apply to this class. Through Hurricane Irma and COVID-19, this incredible group of young people have had to be adaptable. I have been proud to spend 2 years in a classroom with them. As a group, I think there is no higher compliment that I could pay them than to say they have the character, the willingness to learn, and the resilience that I would hope that my own daughter has one day. One of the things that I love about Cedar is the social purpose that the school has in the community. Remember, grade 12, to use the skills that you have learned. Remember to embody attributes such as caring, principled, and open-minded. Use these attributes to give back to your communities, both near and far. Remember what it took to get you here. Remember the moments of joy and remember the moments of fear. Perhaps most importantly, remember to always believe in yourself. People are afraid of meeting new challenges, but you must always believe in yourself. Thank you, graduating class of 2021. I wish you the very best of luck. Cedar will miss you. Your teachers will miss you. And I will miss you. Thank you.
It's all yours. That is, you've got your name on it. Thank you, Mr. Matthews. Much appreciated. The quick note in the program, the video presentation is actually going to occur after the address by the student representatives, for those keeping score. So moving on, I have the pleasure of introducing the commencement speaker tonight, Mr. Percy Roden. I've been very fortunate to know Percy for quite some time as a friend, a family friend, as a parent that he is to three wonderful children, each of whom I've known as a teacher. Percy Roden is the managing director of Meridian Construction Company, a company he founded in 1995 right here in the British Virgin Islands. Percy has a civil engineering background and has over 35 years of experience in the industry. Meridian has grown from strength to strength in the BVI and has executed a number of landmark projects, including the airport terminal at Beef Island, the cruise pier expansion in Roadtown. Through vision and strategy, Percy managed to take the company from a single entity operating the BVI to a successful regional player in the construction industry. As a business owner, Percy prides himself in maintaining good corporate citizenship through quiet philanthropy. Percy has proven himself to be a dedicated member of the BVI community, as many of us know. He's been very passionate and an active member of the Rotary Club of Tortola, which he served as president. And in fact, his efforts in this area led the club on three different occasions to recognize him, making him a Paul Harris Fellow. which is an award given by the Rotary International Organization in recognition of persons in the community that have demonstrated outstanding service to the community through involvement and good citizenship. Percy is also a dedicated sportsman and served as vice president of Tortola Sports Club. And from what I hear, is a pretty decent squash and tennis player. And I guess I need to also add best dressed as well. Percy's mantra for success in life is don't ever give up. And most brilliantly, Percy is a dedicated family man, and his daughter Passua is on stage with us ready to graduate tonight. I've listened to Percy on many occasions, and I'm honored to do so again tonight. Thus, without any further ado, I would like you to help me in welcoming Mr. Percy Roding to the podium.
Sure, I'm a bit nervous. Yeah, you can see that, right? See, that is why I took this, a hard copy, to make sure if this thing doesn't work, then I'm okay. Yep. There you go. Got it. Well. I see some familiar faces there in the audience that I would like to pick on, but I don't think this forum represents anything like that. I shouldn't do that, right? Like Mike Adamson right there sitting, putting his hands over his face. You don't want me to pick on you? Patty Romney over there, not a friend? Good. Governor John Ranking, Honorable Vincent Wheatley, Deputy Premier Dr. Nathaniel Wheatley, Minister of Education and Culture, proud parents, guests, graduates, good evening. A warm good evening to everyone. Permit me to reposition this podium here because I want to make eye contact with the graduates. Yeah? These are the guys I want to pick on today. So, how are you guys doing? You're looking absolutely stunning. Absolutely. I consider this an honor to be invited to address the graduating class of 2021, and I take this opportunity to express my gratitude to Cedar International in this capacity. Congratulations, class of 2021. Let's give them a resounding round of applause. Let's hear it for them. I also want to take this opportunity to congratulate the parents, the grandparents, aunts, uncles, brothers, sisters, and any other family members and friends who stood by this class and made today possible. You deserve this as well. So let's hear it for you. I must confess that when I was somewhat surprised at being asked to deliver the commencement speech. Let me digress here for a bit. I was having lunch with a family a couple of months ago, and my daughter Paswa said to me, "Dad, I think you might be asked to do the commencement speech at my graduation." I said, "Girl, stop your stupidness." "Nothing, sir." She said, "Oh, yes, that's true. I said, well, you have a lunch and be quiet. And then a couple of weeks ago, maybe 2-3 weeks ago, I got an email from Mr. Crawford. Percy, you were selected. Do you mind? And you can't say no either. I said, okay, boss, not a problem. I'll do it. Feelings of excitement and good vibes started. Accepting the temptation is one thing, but delivering it is another. And that's the truth. It's the honest truth. After thinking about it, my thoughts became, how would I manage these Generation Z? What could I possibly say to them? How can I impart knowledge to a set of intelligent and vivacious young people who would much rather have some high-profile celebrity address them? Is that true? I know I'm not Push Pop, one of the local celebrities, or Barack Obama, or the likes of Oprah Winfrey. Yet, as I pondered on it, I saw the opportunity to give some insights into a journey called life. Being a baby boomer myself, and I've had years of experience. I know that you all have plans for this evening, but bear with me for a few minutes, yeah? Don't pull out your iPhones or your Androids and start texting or going through your IG profiles. Just bear with me for a second. I won't take long. I was thinking about this speech. What should I say? I figured the best way to keep your attention would be to probably talk about some popular stuff or some entertaining stuff. But while that may be good, you are at a critical crossroads in your life, and thus the moment calls for honest and hard-knocks facts on the life and the quest for success. Crossroads, yeah? Crossroads, you may ask. How many of you have plans for this chapter in your life? Right. Some of you have applied to universities to further your education. Some of you have decided to take a gap year, something I'm yet to understand. Maybe to relax, to travel, or determine what you want to do with your life. Some of you have decided to start working for several reasons. Earn an income for college, get experience, or just take time off for academic studies. Whatever the reason is, I think I can safely say that there's a plan, and planning is good. Yes, planning is good. When I was a kid, I'm sure that most of the adults in this room can identify with this. I wanted to get older fast and be a man, have my own car, make my own rules, have my own money. But as the years passed, again, all the adults in this room can attest to that. Life comes at you fast, really, really fast. And too often, our best laid plans and dreams are not realized. Whatever your plans are, or whatever you're contemplating for your future, I wish to leave with you no more than 5 points. 5 it will be. I know you hate it when someone promises you that they're going to speak to you for a while, and then 10, 12 points later, they're still talking. You can also thank Paswa, who insisted that I keep it short. Keep it short, Dad. Don't take it long. Huh? Feel free to hold me to this. Right? Number one, dream big. Yes, dream big. I've observed that too many people, old folks included, stop dreaming and are afraid to take the necessary risk to be more than just average. Instead, they settle for just fitting in. Yeah, fitting in. It's also my observation that too many are contented to ride the coattails of their parents, their friends, and others. There's a 1941 Billie Holiday song, way before your time, mine and your parents and friends and guardians. The chorus, and still the sentiments, are just as valuable today. The chorus goes like this. Mama may have, papa may have, but God bless the child that has its own. That's got its own. That's got its own. Many of life's most outstanding achievements. Thank you. Many of most life's outstanding achievements required going outside your comfort zone. Going outside your comfort zone. I'm talking about dreaming. About more than you are right now. About dreaming about more than your parents are. I'm talking about having dreams of being the next Mark Zuckerberg, Kylie Jenner, Naomi Osaka, or any other successful person that you admire. I'm talking about dreaming big to make a difference, possibly to change the world. I remember as a young man not too long ago, and don't ask my age, I'm not going to tell you that either. It's my business. I sat in a sermon similar to yours, contemplating what was going to be of my life. I won't lie to you and give you the impression that I was always successful or that everything I tried turned out well. On the contrary, I failed from him more times than I have been successful. But I never stopped dreaming. I always knew I wanted to have my own business. It was always my dream to do so. Yet, despite all my failures, I kept on dreaming and planning. I kept on believing and pushing forward. I kept on moving outside my comfort zone, doing more, wanting more. To this day, I am still dreaming of doing different things, creating new businesses. Take it from me, a dreamer. Yes, I keep dreaming. Keep dreaming. Dream big about what you want to achieve. Yes, dream big about the life you want to lead and the difference you want to make. Dream big about the person you want to become. And dream big because you just might surprise yourself. Dream big because until you do so, you have no idea what you're capable of. As long as there's breath, keep dreaming and dream big. That's number one. We're moving there. We're getting there. Number two, quickly, brisk. Take risks, but they have to be calculated risks. They have to be. You can't just walk down the street and recognize something. You figure, well, I'm going to take a risk at that. No, they have to be calculated. You want to make sure that you win all the time. It's okay to dream, but you need to do more than dream. You need to get to it. Thomas Edison is attributed to have said that, quote, a dream without a plan or action is a hallucination. Yes, a dream without a plan or action is a hallucination. As a young person, you are expected to engage in risky behavior. Do things that will make your parents question your mental aptitude and threaten to make you see the other side of them. Maybe slap you upside the head a little bit, but not so hard to hurt you, right? But those aren't the type of dreams that I'm talking about. And they're not the type of risk that I'm talking about either. Like most, I started working for others from the bottom and doing whatever task I was given. I wasn't always proud to start at the bottom or do what some may call menial labor. Sometimes to get to the top, you have to start at the bottom. And it's undoubtedly, as you have heard before, it's not where or how you start, but how you finish that counts. It's not where or how you start, but how you finish that counts. If you were to look up stories of many successful people, you'd find that many experienced failures before their successes. Many started at the bottom and experienced rejections, being told no quite often. Many suffered experienced feelings of giving up, but they never did. Instead, they continued to dream and took risks time after time to make their dream a reality. Many use these failures as catalysts to take the necessary risk of stepping outside and pushing forward. When I started Meridian Construction back in 1995, I know that makes me sound old again, I had no idea how successful it would become. I just knew that I had to get out of my comfort zone and do what I had been dreaming of. I had decided to take that risk of investing in my dream. Dream big and take calculated risks. So class of 2021, graduates, while dreaming of your future and purpose, you must take risks. Whether it means overcoming shyness to perform before a crowd or mustering the courage to speechify before a group of young people, braving your investors or creditors to start your own business, creating or inventing the next big tech device or technology, all comes as a result of taking risks. No doubt. There'll be feelings of unease of not knowing the outcome, and the fear of potential failure, you'll be flooded with many what-ifs. What-ifs. What if I embarrass myself in front of everyone? What if I lose my money that I've invested, or worse yet, investors' funds? What if they don't like me, my product, my service? What if I'm not good enough? What if, what if, what if? Negatives. Don't want to hear that. There are many what-ifs in life. Some you can assume the outcome correctly, others you just can't. That's the nature of life. Very unpredictable. You can only know the outcome after you let go of your fears and give it a try. Yes, give it a go. Let a fear be your motivation. Instead of letting it stop you from taking actions, risk something for something you desire more. Try answering those with another what if. Right. What if it works? What if I'm successful? What if it turns out great? Taking risks is frightening. The future is daunting. The unknown is scary. But we can't afford not to move forward and take action. Whenever you encounter risk, search within your heart. Dig deep within yourselves and go after your dreams. You may fail, but you may very well succeed. And if you fail, do not see that as a defeat, but as a lesson learned. Instead, step back. Look at what you didn't do well or could have done differently. Fix those and get back at it again. Yes, this will require courage and resilience. However, you are more likely to succeed by learning and continuing to give it a try. Everyone who have had a dream realized has gone beyond, dig deeper, and face their fears. They have taken risks. Remember this, and you can't forget this. No guts, no glory. No risks, absolutely no reward. No guts, no glory. No risks, no rewards. Number three, we're almost there. Have high standards. High standards for yourself and others. Too many people live their lives below average and are comfortable living in mediocrity. They take the attitude, it's not a big deal. Or it's not that important. It won't make a difference. Such attitudes start early in life. How you view yourself is how you tell others to consider you. First impressions are lasting impressions. If you want others to take you seriously and to grant you the respect and attention you deserve, then you have to have high standards of yourself. When you are unconcerned about the appearance, such as how you dress, how you walk, how you talk, you are telling yourself to accept mediocrity. When you do not put in the time and the effort to deliver the best in your schoolwork, you are again telling your brain it's acceptable to be mediocre. What you practice, you become. I cannot emphasize this enough. I speak from experience where I see workers come to work and are happy to deliver mediocrity. Guys show up on the job without proper attire, walking around with their pants hanging down, you know, not paying attention to details. What do you think happens when it's time to lay somebody off? They're the first to go, for sure. First to go. Not accepting mediocrity means that you set high standards and push yourself to be the best in whatever you do. It means you will hold yourself and others to a higher standard. If you're ambitious and want to impact the world, you should never live your life accepting mediocrity. On the contrary, not accepting mediocrity from yourself will keep you and will make you extremely successful. Standards are essential for all aspects of life. Career, appearance, friends, life partners, home life, the way we raise our children, and beyond. So then, practice doing everything with the high standards. In what may seem like a significant and insignificant act of making up your bed correctly, being mindful of how you dress and how you speak, how you talk, do your schoolwork, giving your best to your place of employment, you will cultivate the habit of excellence. You become what you practice. As the Greek philosopher Aristotle is credited for saying, we are what we repeatedly do. Excellence, then, is not an act, but a habit. So make it a habit to strive for excellence in everything you do. Number four. Some water. Number four, never stop learning. Never stop learning. Today marks the end of your high school learning, and many of you, if not all, will move on to completing a bachelor's or master's degrees. Some of you may even go on to pursue doctorates in medicine and philosophy. But after so many years of learning, you may very well vouch that's the end of education for you. But I want to encourage you to never stop learning. Never stop learning. Understand this. Learning is not what you get from formal institutions. That's education. Learning is what you do for yourself to keep growing and for self-improvement. It is increasing knowledge in an evolving world. Learning, therefore, is a never-ending process. Every time Apple releases a new device or a new technology is released and we make an effort to know how to use these, that is learning. Education has its merits, but you need continuous learning to endure and overcome in life and succeed in your goals. You'll finish your degrees and become accomplished, academically that is, but that education will take you so far. The world does not revolve around textbooks or curriculums. As important as these are, you still have to have the mindset to keep growing and improving. I make it a point to keep learning. I read books, I watch informative programs. I stay informed of how the world is evolving and whatever new technologies are presented. Maybe that's how I'm able to manipulate this piece of iPad here. Embracing change and learning new things help you train your brain to adjust to new ideologies, new methods, and ways of doing things, new ways of making the best of this one life given to you. To keep up with the advancement of a changing world, you need to constantly keep yourself updated with the new skills and knowledge. Being open to learning helps you think outside the box, look for options, look for different perspectives, and try different ways. Learning keeps you informed, it keeps you engaged and empowered. Therefore, it is imperative for both personal and professional development. And finally, number five. We right there. Is this mine? Thank you. Having a plan for your life. You must have a plan for your life. That's number five. Planning your life is one of the most meaningful and practical ways to achieve what you want. Truthfully, nobody plans to fail, they just simply fail to plan. Our more positive way of looking at it are five P's. Proper planning prevents poor performance. Yes, proper planning prevents poor performance. Think about this for a second. You generally plan for many things you don't even consider. Some of you, adults included, make plans for the new year. Some of you call it resolutions. Whatever it is, you actively plan to improve your life and go after your dreams. These plans may include losing weight, eating healthy, taking on a sport, reducing or cutting out drinking, starting a new business or a new career, and being more friendly or spiritually minded. Regardless of the desired goal, we will most likely write these down in a notebook or a journal, or for the techier ones, on your smartphones. After we have written this down, we actively, at least for the first 3 months, according to statistics, work at it. And while at month six, we look back and see we haven't made much progress, we maintain the plan and plan to get back at it. Having a written plan keeps you accountable to yourself. The bottom line is that there is a plan. Having a successful life with meaning, happiness, and fulfillment is no different. Therefore, Planning your life is equivalent to having a roadmap that helps you reach your desired goals in life. While life is an adventure, it would not be very smart to live aimlessly, hoping to get to your goal eventually. Having a plan for your life will give you a sense of purpose. What am I going to do with the years given to me? How will I contribute and impact the world? That's what you're going to ask yourself, yeah? Planning should be applied to both small and significant aspects of your life. For example, minor things such as learning a sport, joining a club, learning a new skill, to important decisions like which college will you attend, the subject that you will major in, the career path that you will take, the age at which you will get married and start a family, should all be planned. Having a plan for your life keeps you passionate about what you want and motivates you to go after your dreams. In addition, it keeps you accountable to yourself. The act of engaging in strategic planning for your life can guarantee much more success than that of just going with the flow. Bluntly speaking, graduates, failing to plan is the same as planning to fail. In closing, yes, despite how we dream, take risks, have high standards, continue to learn and plan, the words of Scottish poet Robert Burns remains valid. The best laid plans of mice and men can still go wrong. There are no straight lines in life, and no manuals pass on to you. However, what I can pass on to you is a wisdom of experience. So, graduates, class of 2021, this is your mission, should you accept. As you are entering this new chapter of your lives, I want to implore you to dream big, take calculated risks, have high standards for yourself and others, keep on learning, and make a plan for your life. You will encounter obstacles. There will be doors closed to you, and you will get no's. The plans may not always work out. Some dreams may not be realized. Nonetheless, never give up. If a door is closed, look for a window. Find another way. Change the trajectory, not the destination. You may fall. Disappointments will come. But get up, modify the plan, and work at it again. Keep pushing forward. Rest if you must. But as John Greenleaf in his famous poem said, don't you dare give up. Don't you dare quit. The world is yours for the taking. Be brave, class of 2021. Congratulations, and God bless you.
Percy, thank you. Thank you very much. Well, really well done. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Ben.
That's good for you. On behalf of us, thank you very much. I like the new perspective here. Thank you very much, Percy. Thank you very, very much. Well, grade 12, let's see here. I think we've come to the point in the night where once we are done, I will forever refer to you as the graduates of the class of 2021. We're getting close. Enjoy this moment. This is certainly one of those special life moments. So be proud. Smile. Smile for the cameras. Smile for the relatives. All right? So without any further ado, will the class of 2021 please rise so we can begin to award the well-earned Cedar International School diplomas? I'm going to call Mr. Crawford to help me out. sure I get it right. All right, well, I'll call out each student's name and Mr. Crawford will hand out the diplomas. The diploma reads as follows. Cedar International School has conferred on student name a college preparatory high school diploma, together with all the rights, the privileges, and honors appertaining thereto, in consideration of the satisfactory completion of the course prescribed by the Board of Trustees. In witness thereof, the undersigned have affixed their names and the seal of Cedar International School on this day, 28th of June, 2021. So please, let's make some noise and help me congratulating our first graduate, Amelia Adamson. Lakeisha Allen. Haley Chomiak. Janiqua Collymore. Joshua Callard. Michaela Diaguiar. Kenesia Duncan. Maximilian Esser. Jasper Forte. Jake Hallett. Anton Lachota. Luca Reich. Maxwell Reshetiloff. Passoa Rodin. Kiara Woodley. Robert Juan Williams. Thank you. And Tania Van Zoost, who is not in attendance tonight. All right, graduates, you can flip your tassels now. Let's make some noise. You did it. All right. You feel like graduated. All right. Well, now I'm going to call up two of our superstar Cedar graduates to the podium to lead us on through the night. I'm going to call up Josh Callard and Janiqua Collymore, please.
Hello and good evening. It is a privilege for us to welcome students, family, friends, and faculty to Cedar International School's graduation ceremony. Before we continue, we'd like to express our gratitude to our principal, Mr. Pasco, director, Mr. Crawford, and our DP coordinator, Mr. Thibault, as well as faculty and staff for their unwavering support during our trials and tribulations. A special thank you to all of our parents and teachers who persevered in the face of adversity and who should be acknowledged with our success. These are the people who got us to where we are today, and we are forever grateful. We'd also like to thank all of the people who have expressed their support for us and their enthusiasm in anticipation for this speech. It is a tremendous honor for us to give this speech on behalf of our classmates this evening. Today, we stand before you with a great sense of pride and gratification. Standing on this podium, I'm feeling a mix of emotions: sadness, delight, contentment, fulfillment, and I am certain that many of my fellow graduates can empathize with me. Over the last 6 years, my peers and I have poured so much effort into being able to stand here before you all this evening and celebrate our achievements. As my peers can attest, it was by no means easy, but all of that grit and determination that we have put into our work has only made this moment better. The people who are sitting on this stage have endured Hurricane Irma, the coronavirus pandemic, and spending our final year inside of a circus tent.
She'll be back, don't worry. What's up, graduates? How you doing tonight? But through all of this, leaving Cedar has been one of the strangest experiences of them all. Having spent the better part of 16 years running through the halls of Cedar, except on the red tiles, leaving felt like saying goodbye to my second home and my second family. But this is not the case, because even when I'm gone, I will carry what I've learned from Cedar with me for the rest of my life, and also what I've learned from these beautiful people right next to me. From our first years penned inside Lower Kindy, with our bright eyes, open arms, and an endless supply of Jasper Big Head jokes, we were ready for whatever the world might throw our way. How ignorant we were then, taking for granted great things such as golden time, nap time, and time. Life was easy then. Learning about shapes, weird shapes they called letters, and even weirder shapes they called numbers, which our little brains didn't realize would become our mortal enemy in the future. Sorry, Missy, wherever you are. Oof. Here in pre-kindy, Miss Johnny taught us how to run, that little ring of logs and those five giant rocks taught us how to jump, and our imaginations taught us how to fly. And fly we did, right through kindy over that little green fence into primary. We had a variety of pets in primary, ranging from hamsters to an adult Caribbean tree boa. That got loose, and we couldn't find it for 3 months in the classroom. We also had the BDO League, where Tania, Janiqua, RJ, Luke, and I used to represent Cedar School against the other schools. And we all played football. Well, Tania, RJ, Janiqua, and I would play football. Luke has spent the entire time screaming at me. He may look calm now, but believe me, I know why he's related to Coach John. Entering high school, we may have lost a lot from Irma, but we're joined by many amazing faces such as Kinesia, Kiara, Maxwell, and Paswa. We also had some incredibly competitive classmates in high school, such as Jake, who decided he was going to try and break the world record for the most amounts of lates in 1 year. Or Anton, who wanted to try and miss as many extended essay deadlines as humanly possible. 1 year late. Excuse me. I could stand here telling you every story from high school, from Amelia learning how to bake synonym buns, not to be confused with cinnamon buns, from Haley getting stuck in one of the art room chairs so Mr. Haynes had to cut her out with a hacksaw, or Lakeisha with so many different hairstyles, it's hard to keep track. And after all that, fueled by burning passion, unwavering determination, and the nice little chocolates Mr. Tebow gave to us every Friday, we charged full force into our final exams.
And now we're here, on this stage, where the same tall folks we've admired our entire lives have sat here before us, peering down on our classmates for the last time, reflecting on some of the great talents and attributes of the graduating class of 2021 has become customary when preparing for this important occasion. Our class is recognized by those who know us as a close-knit group of students who are diverse, hardworking, and compassionate. We've always been dedicated, focused, and role models for perseverance. Because of the many memories we shared and the special bond we've established over time, our class has been known for being both cohesive and intimidating. So, as we embark on the next chapter of our lives, we have a few words of advice that we'd like to share with you. Keep in mind all of the memories we once shared. As Muhammad Ali once stated, "Don't count the days, make the days count." Fellow graduates, we encourage you to take forward all of your past experiences, both good and bad. Embrace future opportunities and be inspired to express yourself. Don't let your mistakes define you, but don't be afraid to make mistakes. Be true to yourself and make your future. Do not let your future make you. Don't limit yourself. Be courageous in taking the next step. Fear is a reaction, but courage is a decision. So as you enter the most uncertain and thrilling part of your lives, go confidently in the direction of your dreams. There are no limits to how many experiences you may have, and you can't learn without making mistakes.
I hope that the class of 2021 will walk out of here feeling proud of their accomplishments. But you can't stop here. Don't let your best work stagnate you. Let your achievements and your best work motivate you and show that you can go even further and achieve even more than you previously imagined. Your best work isn't your limit. It's a stepping stone in a long path. And as the wise, kind words of Coach John, don't admire it, keep going. Don't hold back yourself. And take it from someone who's spent the majority of my life locked in the classroom with you. Every single one of you has something great inside of you. Even if you don't see it yet, and even if you think that something isn't significant, it is. Don't let your passions become your hobbies. Follow them. You've come a long way, endured so many things, such as Irma, the pandemic, and sitting on stage in front of everyone you know wearing a plate on your head. This isn't the end of high school. It's the beginning of your life. And to wish you on your way, I heard that poems go quite well here, so I wrote a short one for you guys. From Galapagos tortoises to Ecuador's bikes, from exhibition to Sage Mountain hikes, from Tortola to St. John, where we lived in huts, from the night walk we did with such powerful struts. From giant storms to a global sickness, these years passed us by with such awful quickness. And from hella hot tents, power cuts, and teacher sweat stains, we endured every single one of those pains. And from the bottom of my heart to the very top of my chest, I wish every single one of you the absolute best. You taught me so much, and I really mean that, like how you taught me that I'm actually fat. And how the world is as big or as small as you wish it to be, and how you should make it your oyster, bon appetit. And if one of you gets rich and switches their gear, just remember your pal Josh, who did your graduation speech every year. All right, so now we're going to go on to a short video which I made to commemorate the class and to have a quick laugh before we all leave. So if I could invite the class to once again walk down the stairs, get your cardio on, and we'll get on with the show.
I would say, don't forget your passions.
Never be afraid. Changes are good. Now you're ending a chapter in life. You're starting a new one.
Don't forget to be crazy every now and then.
Party best.
Where did we go wrong? Hey there.
everywhere. You're not gonna know what hit you. Frank! Frank! I will find you.
Thank you.
Oh, man. Well done, Josh. Fantastic. Well done, class of 2021. I got to get myself together here. We have another treat in store to follow that. So I would now like to call one of our another absolute Cedar superstar graduates, Haley Chomiak, is going to come on up and sing us a song and showcase one of her many talents and amaze us as usual. So let's give her, we'll wait till she gets going there. Let's give her lots of support and make some noise for her.
Thank you, Mr. Pasco. So, first of all, I would love to say that, actually, you know what? I want to thank my family and God for bringing me here tonight because I would not be here without them. Now, parents, students, teachers, leaders, tonight is to represent the end of a chapter. As sad as it is, the end of this chapter, there comes a new. And as my class of 2021, because we made it, we will look forward to the future and we will remember to stay forever young.
Let's dance in silence, dance for a while. Heaven can wait, we're only watching the skies. Hoping for the best, but expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not? Let us die young or let us live forever. We don't have the power, but we never say never. Sitting in a sandpit, life is a short trip. The music's for the sandman. Can you imagine when this race is won? Turn our golden faces into the sun. Praising our leaders for getting in tune. The music's played by the madman. Forever young, I wanna be. Stay young. It's so hard to get old without a cause. I don't want to perish like a fading horse. Youth is like diamonds in the sun, and diamonds are forever. So many adventures couldn't happen today. So many songs we forgot to play. So many dreams screaming out of the blue. We'll let them come true. Do you really want
Thank you all so much for coming tonight. It's been a wonderful journey with you guys, and I know I'll see you in the future.
Mic drop? Just kidding. I can't afford this.
Well done, Haley. Thank you very, very much. Another big round of applause for Haley for being bold, risk taker, coming up here. Graduates, come back up on the stage one last time so we can get photos after I'm done saying a few thanks. Your photos, that's right. Now is photo time. For the alumni wall, indeed. You got it, please. Yeah. Grade 12, I know we've said it before tonight, but we're so very proud of each and every one of you. What you've accomplished in your secondary school career at Cedar has been nothing short of remarkable. You've been through so much in the past 4 years, as our videos and stories and pictures show. And to be a part of your journey is, like I said in the beginning, truly inspiring for me as an educator. You're strong, you're resilient, you're like no other class, as Mr. Matthews pointed out. You're the class of 2021, and we are exceptionally proud of you. I want to take this moment just to thank our secondary faculty team, who I'm sure you can agree have been truly amazing this year. Their patience, care, adaptability has never been more inspiring than what has been on display this academic year. Have a round of applause for our secondary faculty. Back to the class of 2021. Always remember, you will always be part of the Cedar family, and we're always here for you. I'd like to thank the H. Laverty Stout Community College at Eileen Parsons Auditorium for the use of this wonderful venue. I'd like to give thanks to our honored guests, our honored speakers, our honored faculty members, parents, well-wishers, and students for their support throughout this year. I have nothing but gratitude to be a part of this each and every year, and I thank you. We wish everyone to be safe, be well, and one last round of applause for the class of 2021. I'm signing off to the class of 2021. Have a wonderful night. You can stay up here for some pictures as well. Thank you, everybody. Have a good night.